here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, shooting a new episode of a new show called The Undercard with Ellie Segback. And today we're going to feature the up-and-coming fighters from right here, the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy. Check it out.
You know what? Machines, I just reprogrammed their minds. I said, don't get out of line, just don't get out of line. Don't get out of line, just don't get out of line. You know we're back on the scene, back like it's fine. No.
Oscar Diaz, you're from Oxnard, California. You train at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy. What's your record right now?
I have no fights.
No, the amateur. You're up and coming. You haven't turned pro yet.
32 wins with like 5 losses.
And why do you love?
Check the books.
Why do you?
Bring the book.
All right, come on.
That's what I thought. Fuck
come on, Marcos. Yeah.
You can't know.
Why do you love being a boxer?
I don't know. I just love it.
Did your parents name you after Oscar De La Hoya?
No.
No, there's some fighters that, you know, like Cash Flow, his name is Floyd. His father named him after Floyd Mayweather.
Hey, my son's named after Marcos Antonio Barrera.
Yeah.
But it's Marco Antonio. And then my daughter, her name is named after Leila Ali, Leila. And then my newborn, not my newborn, but my 10-month-old, she's named after Mia St. John. What the fuck have the fighters for? And then my next one, I don't know who it's going to be.
What you have to name one after Robert, no?
Ellie, get the fuck out of here. Man, smack this motherfucker. Do it. Man,
I can't reach him.
Go.
What's up, Ellie?
How are you doing? Congratulations on your victory.
Thanks. I'm back to Salido.
Why?
This motherfucker acts like he knows what he's doing.
Maybe he does know.
Robbie, don't want to take Robert's advice. No, shut the fuck up. I know what I'm doing. I'm going to take you on water, you're a fucking best friend. He hasn't heard me in the first round, but this fucker. He got tired. I knew what I was doing. That was the plan.
You're a bitch, fool. You got to fucking listen. That's why the fucking Robert's there, fool. He sees shit that you can't see. But you act like you fucking, I know what I'm doing. Don't do that shit.
Was that your first fight in your life?
No. Why? A long time, about 3 years.
He did good. He knocked the motherfucker out.
I saw it. What's his record now?
Fuck, I don't know.
4-1.
4-1?
Yeah. 4-1.
You're an up-and-coming fighter, you're 4-1. What's it like to have a star trainer like Robert Garcia work with you?
Don't even ask that motherfucker.
you know this fucking answer, fool.
Why? What's his answer?
You don't even need Robert in the corner.
You drink Vaseline on water.
They say what? You drink Vaseline instead of water?
No, it's a great pleasure. You know, I have Robert Garcia in my corner. He's a great trainer. He's the best trainer, I believe. So, you know, just like he said, it's how the ring is.
Everybody is that fortunate. Not every up-and-coming fighter can have a star trainer of the year 2011 to work with them.
Yeah, exactly.
So what advantages do you see having such a trainer with you?
All the advantages, actually. In every aspect. He's smarter. Obviously, he's smarter than every other trainer out there. He's better than every trainer out there. He knows how to give his fighters good condition. So
what advice has he given you in your recent fight?
What advice has he given me? Well,
Brandon Rios is laughing because he says, you had wax in your ears and you weren't listening.
Yeah, I was being stubborn in my fight. You know, I felt like I had control of it. Like, I had a little game plan in my head, and which I still play it off. Like, Robert, you know, he gave me good advice. You know, he told me to keep my hands up.
So Irving, how far do you want to go in boxing?
Yeah, as far as I could take it, you know. As far as it could go, I'm not, you know.
The one-man team right there.
Yeah, just as far as I could take it. I just love fighting. I like being in a ring. I like being around a big crowd, and I just love it.
You work hard. You're here every day.
Yeah.
You run more than everybody. You train longer hours. Everybody trains 2 hours. You train 8.
Hey, it's not even. Not 8. They're exaggerating.
Okay, how many hours do you train?
Maybe about 4.
4?
5?
No, seriously, how many hours does he train, Brandon?
Like 5?
How many hours does every other boxer on the planet train?
3, 2, 1.5? 1.5, 3. What if he trains like 5?
You train 5 hours a day, you're so dedicated. What would you do if there was no boxing?
Go to school and find another profession.
Like what?
I already went to school. I'm a nurse, certified nurse.
That's good. If anybody gets injured here, did you know that? That he can actually help you?
I'll still call the doctor. I'll still call the doctor.
That's really good, because you know why? Irving, the medical profession, you'll always have work. Somebody will always be sick.
I don't know what you're running for.
Jesus what? Jesus what? Perez? What do you know about Jesus Perez? He's an up-and-coming fighter right here at the gym.
He's all right. He's coming up. At first, we had to fucking tease his ass because he left the gym for a bitch.
What?
Not for a bitch, but for his girlfriend. He was all scared.
You left the gym for a girl? He's denying that, Brandon.
Your daddy said that he was all whooped on a girl and that he loved her so much that he didn't want to, and she left him.
He even had a job and everything, she left him.
So, Jesus Perez, you're an up-and-coming fighter here at the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy. Have you had any professional fights yet?
No.
So you're part of the next generation of boxers?
Yeah.
What's it like to be here at the gym?
It's good, it's pretty good. I like training.
Why do you love boxing? Why this sport?
I just love boxing.
You just enjoy it?
Yeah.
How old are you now?
I'm 20.
20 years old. How far do you see yourself going?
Until I get thrown.
Oscar Diaz, what do you think about his skills, Brandon?
Well, he's a southpaw. We call him zurdo.
Why?
That means lefty. He's a southpaw. You know, he's coming from an amateur. I guess he had a good background. I don't really know him personally, but from in the gym, he's all right. You know, he got good skills. He helps us spar. He helps Pelos a lot. Who else have you helped? You haven't helped me because I haven't had a softball. Who else have you helped here?
Boxing everyone. My head.
I asked boxing champion Brandon Rios if he had any advice for up-and-coming fighters, especially once they become successful.
Theme for success to all the prospects, everybody that's coming up, don't change for shit. Stay yourself 100%. Just because you get fame, don't change for shit. Just because you make money, don't change for shit. Stay 100%.
Don't
stay
go Hollywood?
Yourself. Stay yourself 100%. That's all I got to say. I forgot. That's number one thing.
What if I become really famous and I start dressing like Larry King? Is that okay with the bow tie and a striped shirt and a suspenders?
If you, whatever, how you dress, I don't care. But as long as you don't change for shit, your personality, the way you are, the way you brought up, don't change for shit. Don't forget about the small people. Remember everything that you came from and your roots.
Great advice. Don't change.
Don't change.
So there you have it. Stay tuned for more of the On the Card with Ellie Seckback for ESNewsReporting.com from the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.